Everyone, welcome to LTE++. So today we are going to discuss about rank indicator, and in my previous tutorial we have already discussed about that CQ and PMI. Okay, so let's start rank indicator. Okay, so to understand this concept, I'll give you example first. Okay. Suppose this is my E node P, okay, and this is the coverage area of my E node P, okay, and I have a UE located at cell center, okay, this is my UE, okay. Cell center means good radio conditions. Good radio conditions means RSRP, RSRQ, and SNR will be good. Okay. So suppose this UE is moved from this location to this location. Okay. So as you are able to see that this UE has been moved to cell edge location. Okay, so at cell edge we already know that radio conditions are poor, right? Means poor RSRP, RSRQ, poor SNR. Okay. So once UE reached at this location, so this UE will send a feedback to E node B. See, first UE will decode the reference signal, okay, and UE will estimate downlink channel conditions or radio conditions. This I have already told you in previous tutorials. So for more detail, please refer my all the tutorials that I have made on MIMO. Okay, so first UE decoded the reference signal, and now UE estimate the downlink channel condition. Okay, now after estimating downlink channel condition, UE will send RI value equals to 1. Okay, so once E node B received this RI value 1, so this E node B will change its transmission mode to TX diversity, okay. TX diversity when UE is at cell edge. So in TX diversity, what E node B will do? E node B will transmit same data from these two antenna, okay. And sometimes we call these antenna or antenna ports as layer also, okay. So both the layers will have the same information, okay. Why we are changing the transmission mode of E node B to transmit diversity mode? Because at this location radio conditions are poor, so there are huge chances that due to fading or signal attenuation or noise, our signals could be lost, okay. The transmitted signals from E node B could be lost. So in TX diversity mode, suppose signal from antenna port 0 got lost, okay. As we are using TX diversity, so it might be possible we have sent this signal, this signal with some delay, okay, with some time delay, okay, as we do in time diversity, okay. So in that case, there are chances that this signal from TX2 antenna will be reached to its destination successfully, okay. So this is the advantage of TX diversity. What's the advantage? It's providing reliability, or robustness to transmitted signals from E node B. Okay, so that's why E node B changed its transmission mode to TX diversity. Okay, let's read this thing again. If UE report the rank indicator value 1 to E node B, E node B will start sending the data in TX diversity mode to UE. This I have explained to you. Okay, what are the advantages and why transmit diversity has been used as a transmission mode at E node B side. Okay, and if UE report rank indication to E node B will start sending the downlink data in MIMO mode. So let's say after some time, this UE is moved to this location. Okay, this is again cell center location. Okay, so now it will report RI. First it will decode the reference signal and now UE will report rank indicator value as 2. So when E node B receives this RI equals to 2, so E node B will change its transmission mode from TX diversity to MIMO mode. MIMO mode, or it's better to say special multiplexing mode. Special multiplexing, I have already explained this term to you in my previous tutorial, so I would like you to refer that tutorial. Okay, so in special multiplexing, so both the antennas, that is TX1 and TX2, will carry different information, right? Like TX1 is carrying S1 information and TX2 will carry S2 information, okay, to this UE. By doing so, our throughput value will be increased. Okay, remember here we are not providing reliability to our signals. Okay, so this is the concept of rank indicator. Okay, and one more thing I would like to tell you. See why we need RI in LTE concept. When UE experience bad SNR and it would be difficult, error prone to decode transmit downlink data. This I have explained to you, right? Once UE is at cell edge location, it's difficult to decode the transmit signal. Okay, so it gives early warning to E node B by stating rank indication value as 1, this RI 1, okay, from cell edge location. When UE experience good SNR, means at cell center location, this location, it passes this information to E node B by indicating rank value as 2. Okay, so rank value as 2 and transmission mode as special multiplexing, which will increase the throughput of UE. Whereas at cell edge, reliability of transmitted signal has been improved. Okay, fine. This is another thing that I would like to tell you, that rank here, rank is 1. Rank and rank indicator both are same thing. So this is 4x4 MIMO, right? So you could see all the 4 layers or 4 antennas are carrying same data, right? So this is TX diversity mode, that is transmit diversity mode. All the layers and antennas are carrying same data. Okay, so rank is 1. This is the case of this cell edge. Okay, and here you could see that all the layers or antenna ports are carrying different data, right? Means throughput will be higher because at same time we are sending multiple data or information to receiver. Okay, so here rank will be 4. Okay, this is the case of this UE. When our UE is at location cell center location, okay, so this is rank 4. Similarly, let's talk about 2x2 MIMO. Okay, so if I'm sending signal और डेटा ए बी सी हेयर, ए बी सी डी ई एफ हेयर. ओके, सो इन दैट इन दिस केस माय आर आई वैल्यू और रैंक इज 2. ओके, वेयर इज इन केस ऑफ 4x4 दिस रैंक और आर आई वैल्यू इज 4. एंड इफ आई एम सेंडिंग सेम इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम टू एंटीनाज लाइक ए बी सी एंड ए बी सी, इन दैट केस माई आर आई वैल्यू विल बी 1. ओके, सो दिस इज द केस ऑफ स्पेशल मल्टीप्लेक्सिंग, दिस इज द केस ऑफ योर टी एक्स डाइवर्सिटी. हेयर आई एम इंक्रीजिंग द थ्रूपुट बट रिलायबिलिटी आई एम नॉट इम्प्रूविंग. ओके, एंड हेयर इन टी एक्स डाइवर्सिटी आई एम इम्प्रूविंग द रिलायबिलिटी ऑफ सिग्नल बिकॉज इफ वन सिग्नल गॉट लॉस्ट आई वुड रिकवर दैट सिग्नल फ्रॉम दैट सिग्नल दैट इज बींग ट्रांसमिटेड फ्रॉम अनदर एंटीना पोर्ट. ओके, सो रिलायबिलिटी इम्प्रूव्ड बट थ्रूपुट मीन्स देर इज नो इम्प्रूवमेंट इन थ्रूपुट. ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट आर आई. Now we are left with one thing, which is types of spatial multiplexing. Okay, so there are two types of spatial multiplexing: open loop spatial multiplexing and closed loop spatial multiplexing. Okay, as we are talking about loop, loop means some feedback from UE to E node B. Okay, so in open loop, only CQI and RI is transmitted from UE to E node B as a feedback, whereas in closed loop spatial multiplexing, along with CQI and RI, UE also send PMI as a feedback to E node B. Okay, and if you look at transmission modes, so this is our transmission mode number 3. Okay, and this is our transmission mode number 4. Transmission mode number 1 is your CISO or CMO, that is single input, single output. Single input, multiple output. Okay, and transmission mode 2 is your TX diversity. Okay, there are multiple types of transmission modes are defined in 3GPP. Okay, so I have explained you 4, and if I am not wrong, TM5 is your multi-user MIMO. Okay, this is TM3 open loop spatial multiplexing, TM4 closed loop spatial multiplexing, TM5 MU MIMO, and I think TM6, I don't remember it right now, TM7 is for beamforming, I think. Okay, so I'll cover this transmission mode in some another tutorial. Okay, so this is all about CQI, PMI and RI. Okay, thanks for watching, and you can put your comments or queries in comment box. Okay, thanks for watching.